Hey, welcome back, knitters. I'm Jana with Purl Together, and in this week's technique video, I want to give you an introduction to cables. So cables are just simply taking stitches and switching places with them and causing a twist. It's really pretty straightforward. Sometimes you can get into some complicated patterns or techniques, but in this video, I just want to show you how to do a basic 2/2 left and right cross to create this cute little owl dishcloth. So as you know, dishcloths are really easy to start with. It's a small project. It's not a super commitment. So look how cute. So really, all that is 6 cables to create that owl. And I just thought that was neat. So join me for this today. But before we get started, I want to give you an opportunity to join me over at patreon.com/purltogether. Becoming a patron allows you to take advantage of some extra perks that I offer. So go check that out if you're interested in joining me for live knit night sessions over Zoom and some other things that we do, like voting for our next knit along, things like that. So the Patreon community is a lot of fun. Speaking of becoming a patron, I want to give a big hearty thank you to 4 new patrons in the last couple of weeks. Thanks so much for joining me and pledging your support. That's how we keep these videos coming each and every week, is patron support. So I couldn't do it without you. Thanks so much to Alita, Paula, Melinda, and Deb. Thanks for joining Purl Together and supporting the channel. All right, to begin with, we're just going to cast on 3 stitches. I just used the long tail cast on. If you need a refresher on doing that, I have a video link in the description down below, so you can review that if necessary. So the first row, we're just going to knit. It's pretty simple. And then turn your work and look at row 2. Whoops, if you can do that without flipping things around. Okay, then turn your work and look at row 2 where it says knit 1 and then increase in the next stitch. I take that to mean increase using this stitch, so I'm going to do a knit front back. So we just go in as if to knit regularly, give yourself a little slack there, and swing your right needle around the back, knit into the back of that same stitch. I'll show you that again in a moment. And then knit 1. So then row 3, we turn our work again, and row 3 is knit 1, increase in the next stitch. So knit front back, so go in as if to knit regularly, pull that yarn through, swing your right needle around, and knit into the back of the same stitch. So you're increasing in that stitch. And then knit to the end of the row. So now we should have 5 stitches. Okay, row 4 says repeat row 3, so we're just going to do the same thing again, where we go in, knit into the first one, use the second stitch as you're increasing, so knit front back, and knit to the end. And you should have 6 stitches at the end of row 4. Okay, so we've done that. Now, with row 5, knit 2, yarn over, knit to the end. All right, knit 2, yarn over, knit to the end. All right, then row 6 through 31, we're just going to repeat row 5. So we're just increasing 1 stitch each time. So knit 1, knit the second, yarn over, knit to the end. That would be row 6. So you can make yourselves a little hash marks if you want, or you can just keep going until you have the prescribed number of stitches. If I've calculated correctly, at the end of row 31, you should have 33 stitches across. So now we're going to begin row 32. And that's just a bit of a setup row so that we can start our cables and have that purled background that makes the owl kind of stand out. So just follow along with row 32 exactly as it says, knit 2, yarn over, knit 11, purl 8, and knit to the end. All right, I'm on row 34, and what I've done is just began the row by knit 2, yarn over, knit 8, and purl 3. So now I've reached the point where I have some cabling to do, and that first abbreviation, C4B, if you'll notice on the first page of the chart, it's worked over the next 4 stitches. So we're going to place the first 2 stitches on the cable needle. So let's talk about cable needles for just a moment. I prefer these little birch cable needles. They're made by Brittany. They come in a 3-pack like this, in 3 different sizes. And I've used these quite a lot. So I'll put a link to these down below in the video description. But I like them because they're tapered. And then there's a little hollowed out kind of a thinner area in the middle to keep your stitches on. But they're lightweight. They're not very expensive. You can also use the metal J-shaped ones or whatever works best for you. But again, if you're interested in these, I'll put a link down below in the description. So the first thing we're going to do is take the first 2 needles and hold them in back of the work. So just slip them off as if to purl. So go in to the first stitch as if to purl and take that off. Do the same with the second. And then we're going to just hang on to them. They just need to hang out here on the back of the work. So hold to the back, just meaning put them on the back. And I usually just kind of hang on to that little needle there. If you have one of those J-shaped ones, you can just let it hang. That's totally fine. But then we're just going to knit the next 2 stitches. And I give that a good little tug because you're going to, you know, try to close the hole that the 2 stitches were holding in the back. You want to kind of close up the hole that those have left and draw those 2 stitches over to the right. Now what we're going to do is knit the 2 from the cable needle. So you're going to want to pull this over to your left, and it feels fiddly, but just let this part hang out. It's not going to go anywhere. And then you're just simply going to knit these 2 stitches off the cable needle. Super easy. So all you've done is traded positions with these 2 stitches and these 2 stitches. We've just twisted them over and switched places with them. That's really all we've done. And that's all cables are, ultimately. And so now we're going to do the same thing with the next 4 stitches, where we're going to take the first 2 stitches and hold them to the front. So we slip as if to purl. You always slip as if to purl, unless the pattern tells you specifically otherwise. So slip those off, hold them to the front this time, knit 2, I just let those hang there, just ignore it. Knit the next 2 stitches from your left working needle. Okay, scooch this needle through so nothing falls off. And then you're gonna knit the 2 stitches off here. So just pull those to the left, ignore this business here, and just knit those 2 off your front needle, being careful not to drop them off this needle like I did. Okay. Let me show you that again. I'll take that out just because I fumbled it. And I'll show you that again. All right, so all I've done is knit those 2 off. I'm pulling these over to the left, and I'm gonna knit those off the cable needle just like normal stitches. Then what we wanna do is put the cable needle down, and then we're just gonna carry on knitting. Actually, we're gonna purl 3. According to the directions, we're going to purl 3. So bring your yarn to the front, purl the next 3, and knit to the end of the row. And we'll see how cool that looks here in a moment. You can see when you look at the picture how those cables there form the base of the owl's body. So that's kind of neat. Let's check it out. Okay. All right. I'm not going to spread this out too much because I don't want to lose anything off the ends. But you can see now how that's going to form the bottom of the owl's body. All right. Let's move on to row 35, 36, all the way until we get to row 42. We don't have any more cable maneuvers. So I'll leave you to knit from row 35 to row 41 on your own. And I'll meet you back here for row 42. Okay, I've arrived at row 42, and I have all these stitches mashed on the needle, pretty much. But what the deal is now is we've increased by doing all these yarn overs, and we reached the width for the widest part of this diamond. So now we're going to start decreasing, as well as doing the owl pattern in the middle here. So we're going to start decreasing back down to make the top half of the diamond. So by doing that, we're going to knit 2 together. So on row 42 is when that begins. So we're just going to knit 1, knit 2 stitches together. And again, the way you do that is to go in as if to knit, on the left side of the second stitch and knit them both together, just like that, okay? And then we'll do our yarn over, knit two together. And the reason you have to knit two together again is because when you do a yarn over, you're maintaining the pattern that we started here, but we don't want to increase another stitch. So we need to decrease away the stitch that we're adding by doing the yarn over. So hopefully that makes sense. So we're going to do another knit two together right here. Then knit nine. We're going to knit up to where we've been doing the purl section on the outside of our yarn on our owl motif. So if you get this where you can look, we have these purl section right here. So we're going to knit up to these three stitches and purl those. Then we're going to be doing, whoops, need to purl that one. And then we're going to be doing our cabling here again. All right, so CB4, if you look at the abbreviations for that, is a cable to the back. So let me grab my cable needle again. And CB4 indicates that we're going to put the first two stitches onto the cable needle and hold them to the back. So CB4 means that it's a cable worked over the course of four stitches in total, and you're holding to the back. So then we're going to knit the next two. And then you'll see me scooch these stitches down because I don't want them to inadvertently come off this left needle. So I kind of scooch that down out of habit while I go and get a hold of the cable needle that's in the back, and we will work those two stitches off the cable needle. And that does feel a little bit tight, but it'll all even out, particularly with blocking. Then the next thing we want to do is cable to the front. So C4F, cable for front. So again, take the next two stitches and slip as if to purl and put them off onto the cable needle, holding it in the front. Knit the next two stitches, and that flops around. I just kind of tend to ignore it. So you'll notice I gave that a good little tug to kind of tighten up this hole. That's going to result from us bringing those two stitches across the back of these two stitches. So then we're going to bring this cable needle around and ignore this, just tuck it back behind and knit those two stitches from your cable needle. And I give this a little tug as well to kind of loosen it up because it is going to feel a little tight as you're pulling it to the left and you're pulling it over across the front of these other two stitches. All right, so you can see how that's making the owl, starting to make the bottom of the owl's head. That's pretty cool. Now purl three and knit to the end. Okay, carry on following the instructions for decreasing and all the knits and purls. That's all it is knits and purls and knit two together at the beginning of each row, all the way until we get to the next cable, which is on row 48. Okay, I'm in the middle of row 48, and I've just done the purl three that comes just before our owl body, and how cute is that? I mean, really, we've only done four cables so far, and just the eyes are just a combination of knits and purls, but that's super cute. We have our last row of cables here, and again, we're just going to do the CB4, which is slip two, onto the cable needle and hold it to the back. Knit the next two from the left needle, ignoring the ones on the cable needle, even if they flip in your face. Straighten that out, and we want to knit the two from the cable needle now that's in the back. Just make sure that, you know, when if it flips around, just make sure that it's not twisted and that those two stitches are lying straight and flat. So we're just going to knit those off. And we've done the C4B. Now we're going to do the one, same thing, but the reverse, where we slip the two off to the cable needle and hold to the front. Knit the next two. And then knit the two from the cable needle, making sure we don't lose any stitches off that left needle there. Tuck that around behind just to get that out of your way, and knit the two from the cable needle that's in the front. Okay. Purl three and knit to the end. So that's easy enough.
Then we're just going to continue following the directions all the way until the end. It's pretty exciting and pretty straightforward. So that's going to look really cute. So I'm going to go ahead and finish this off, just following the row by row instructions, and you can too. And I'll see you at the end and show you how we will bind off after row 81. Okay, I'm at the end of row 78 after repeating that several times. So now we're just going to bind this off. So just a refresher real quick on how to do that. You just go into the first stitch and knit like normal. Go into the second stitch, knit that one as well, and then take the first one, go in underneath with your left hand needle and just pull that right over the top. And that's how you bind off. So we're just going to do that again, pull that second one over the top, first one over the top, the second, and there you have it. Now what I do is leave a little bit of a tail, and I'll go ahead and cut this with my really dull scissors and just pull that through. Tighten that up, and then we'll weave in our ends. And I have ends right here too, because I was using a leftover piece of the same kitchen cotton, and it ran out. So I had to join a new skein, tie a little knot, and then I'll just weave in those tails along the side as well. But here's the owl. Isn't it cute? Super cute. I like that very much.
I hope you enjoyed this little project. I'm going to be making more for sure. I can see a whole flock of owls in my drawer in all different colors. I have a thing about owls. I just love them. So I hope you enjoyed it as well. Check me out over on Patreon. And if you can't support the channel monetarily at this time, that's totally fine. So what's really great is to just give me a thumbs up and be sure to subscribe. Tell your friends about the channel and join me. Keep watching the videos. All right. Thanks so much.